Belgium.
Yeah. Welcome. You can speak Dutch.
Okay, I do Swart.
Swart. Quite an international group. Did I forget anybody? Right. So the main language of this retreat will be English. Let that be light. Okay, just a bit. I'm gonna tell you a bit about the logistics, about this place, and how the retreat is working. So you can be in peace about that. And if you have any questions, if you still have any questions about the retreat, you can come to Ingrid or to me, like the organizers. If you have questions about the place, about your room, maybe a light isn't working or a shower or something, you can also go directly to the people here from Dopersdam, and I'm sure to reception, and they will help you. And if there's nobody there, there's a number, there's like an emergency number even, well, it says that for emergency, you can call the manager. So think about that. Practical, if you take a shower in your room, please, mainly in building 3, but I believe also in building 2, it's best to close the door of the bathroom because the smoke alert is pretty sensitive and it reacts to the steam from the shower. So if you leave, it happens sometimes, you leave the room open and there's smoke alerts, and if it's in the middle of the night, everybody has to be evacuated from that room. You don't want that. I noticed that even in building 3, I thought only building 2, that in front of the doors there are glass doors and there's no curtains. So it may be a bit that you think, well, everybody can see me in my room. David was already talking about the flashing. And I said in my mail that maybe bring something, a cloth, to hang it in front of it. And if you don't have it and you would like it, I brought some garbage bags, black ones, and some tape. So if you want to make it dark, I got some. I brought some stuff for it as well. But my arms are getting too short. Right. Something important about the duties. You have to remember, I sent the mail as well, but like everybody has one day duty. In the kitchen, it means putting the tables and cleaning up again and doing the dishes. It's always 15 minutes before the meal and half an hour after it to do the dishes. And everybody one day. So if it's good, then everybody knows which day you have your duty. Anybody here who doesn't know?
There's a list in the dining room.
If you forgot, in the dining room there's a list with names, so you know which day is your day. There's one change. I thought we had to put the tables for breakfast as well, but that's not necessary because the breakfast is a buffet. So the tables are not set for that, so you don't have to get up extra early. So breakfast is from 8:30 to 9:30, and only after that we have to do dishes. Well. Then, the program I sent you was like a guiding line, but we changed it a little bit. So for today, we had arrived at 11, then this session will be a short introduction session till 12:15, 12:15. Then we'll have lunch, and after lunch we'll continue till 4. So immediately, because it's so short, this we thought it would be better to kick in. So from lunch will be 12:30 till 1:30, and then at 2 o'clock we start again here from 2 till 4. And then at 4, we have coffee and tea in our dining area. And I will give you your keys to your rooms, the people who don't, most of you don't have the key yet. then you'll have till dinner. It will be at 6. You have from 4 till 6 to get settled in your room and check out the area and everything. And then after dinner, we start at 7:30 till I made it 10:30. So I have 3 hours tonight as well. See. And then the coming days, we'll have lunch half an hour later than is in your program, and dinner half an hour earlier than is in your program. So we put more, but I will make it you can see it here. I will write every day what the program is, so if you take you can look it up.
Yeah, they have an iPhone, they can take a photo on their smartphone if they can take it.
Yeah, these days. I'm probably one of the last people on Earth who don't have a smartphone. But you can just take a picture of the program in the morning with your smartphone. These are really high tech people. Techies, they're all techies. Yeah. So, if there's any questions, please let me know. So the rest of the week, the emphasis will be a bit more on the morning session, so like a good strong morning session and a good strong evening session, and then in between we will offer some sessions, maybe one-on-one, maybe meditation, maybe singing, can be, but it's also, the afternoon is more for integration, that you have time, quiet time in the afternoon to integrate what we have done in the other sessions. And if you want, you have plenty of time to go here into nature and go to the beach. And you can rent bikes here on at the open sign as well. Yeah, if you go to reception, you can rent a bike. Yeah. If you bring your coffee and tea to this room, it's okay. Please take it back again and put it on a cart. How do you say that? Trailer thing. Yeah. Trolley, that's the word. Then there's a bar. The area where you get it just now, there's a bar. So if you want, for example, in the evening we can, well, we don't have much time, but if there would be any time in the afternoon, for example, you sit there and you want something to drink, you can just take it yourself. And there's a list, you just put your name and put what you took. And at the end of the week, you can, when you and your keys of your room, you can just pay for whatever you consuming. Get a drink.
It's working well, your logistics are calming. Your voice is over there.
I just checked my list. I guess one last thing is we prepared a book table with books. It's in the room here, in the next room. There are books from David. You want to tell us?
Well, maybe just to share that it's good if everyone comes on time for the sessions.
That one has materials too.
Yeah, so there are books from David in English. So books that weren't available before in the year in the Netherlands haven't been translated yet. But also newest books, also some other books. It's just around the corner here. You can have a look. Buying them is on donation basis. So there's a list with the prices. But there's a box. And so if you take a book, you can put that money, you can, if you really don't have any money, you can put less, if you think you can put more. So that's on donation basis. There are also CDs from Helena, who is going to sing for us as well, so you can first listen if you like it. And if you really like it, then you can buy a CD as well. Marjan is probably also going to sing for us this week. She's also managing the sound system, so if you might have any questions about that, you might even bring around the interruption microphone. Is that an idea? If people have questions, you can wait till you get a microphone so everybody can hear you. Yeah? Well, that's about it for me. Are there any questions now? Right now?
Let's start.
Let's start.
Thank you, Chris. Well, welcome everyone. We have a beautiful sunny day here in the woods, in the forest, to start our 5-day retreat. And you might think of this retreat as the spirit trying to tailor a retreat for you. So that's why we want to hear your ideas, suggestions, if there's topics or themes that you would like to explore in your life, you know, to go much deeper, we can use that to key off of. We want to keep this very practical, so we're not here to just talk about a bunch of theoretical ideas. This is to be very, very practical. So you can think of this retreat as tailored for you. If there's some things, as the retreat's going on over 5 days, that you feel you would find very helpful, it could be anything from a group walk out in nature, or group meditation, one-on-ones, talking to us about issues, maybe the issues you don't feel comfortable bringing up in the larger group, but you feel like you'd like to talk in a smaller kind of intimate setting, please let us know about that. And so we'll all be very active with this retreat, and then Marian will be singing. She's brought some songs, and she'll be gracing us with her songs throughout the 5 days. And also Luz, maybe Luz, you can stand up. Luz is going to be assisting us. She has lived in our communities, she's been on a trek around the world. She's been over in the United States, she's been all the way down to Australia, she's just come from Mexico, and so she's been practicing living a very devoted life in some of our communities around the world. And so if there's ideas and we're engaged in something, doing something else, you can come to Luz and just say, hey, here's something I'd like to reach somebody with, or I'd like to suggest, or whatever. She could be available as well, because she'll be working very closely with us and letting us know anything that is important. So she's going to be very important for this too. So really, I find that the most important thing about spirituality is the practice of it. I always say that spirituality is 1% principle and 99% practice. So if there's anything that we can do to help you with your spiritual practice over the next 5 days, to help deepen you in your practice, or maybe even just inspire you to practice, because there's a lot of things in this world that draw your attention. There can be a lot of distractions. Sometimes I call this world distractionville, you know, so we're trying to be still and stay in purpose and presence, to stay aligned with God, and yet there are so many distractions. So if we can do anything this week that will help you in your daily practice, in your moment-to-moment practice, I think that will be of great benefit to you for your entire life. Because if you get into good habits with spiritual practice, if you feel inspired, if you feel drawn, if you feel deepening in your devotion, then it's going to come so much easier. And in the end, I think you'll find that it's actually quite easy to live a devoted life. It's hard to live a distracted life, even though many of us have to find that out the hard way. We get off into all kinds of things, and then we go, whoa, where did I get off here? How did I get off here? I want to just come back to simplicity. So hopefully this week will help bring you into clarity and simplicity. Hopefully this week will also help to demystify spirituality, in the sense that there is a certain sense of mysteriousness around it, but I feel like once you start to come deeper into that peace, that everything gets very simple, and the complexity starts to fall away, and therefore it's less mystifying, and more, aha, recognition after recognition, that is a beautiful way to live your life, just taking one moment at a time and recognizing and recognizing. That's been a prayer in my heart for many years, is to Spirit, make it obvious. Make it obvious for me. Show me the way. Reveal the way. So we'll do a brief introduction of all of ourselves here, just so you're familiar with us, and I think you'll get to know us much more as we go along, as you interact with us and share and question. My pathway has been with A Course in Miracles since 1986, and it's taken me into a very devotional life of living moment by moment and living in trust. It's taken me all over the world, to over 40 countries. It's also taken me out of what most people would call a typical human life, because most human beings don't travel as much as I've traveled. I've kind of been used by the Spirit to speak through the character of David and go to many countries and meet with many, many people. So it's a bit unusual that way. And most people have jobs and careers. I was told by Jesus internally when I was in my late 20s that I would not have a career in this lifetime. So I said, oh, to be told that in your 20s, it's like, that's going to be interesting. I had to talk to Jesus and say, well, money doesn't grow on trees. And he said, yes, I know you believe that. So it's been very interesting to see how I've been provided for since my late 20s into my late 50s. It's been about 30 years of just trusting and having things come to me in very unconventional ways, but they always come. Whatever seems to be needed to serve the plan is always provided. And that's been very important to me. And I would have to say with everyone here, we'll all be able to share from our experiments with opening to divine providence, letting the presence of love provide and lead the way and show the way. Instead of working jobs for earthly bosses, we've had the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and Jesus is like our inner boss, guiding us, directing us. And I have to say the perks are amazing. You're like always on vacation, and it's quite joyful and happy. You have all kinds of wonderful benefits that you get that don't really come in the corporate world. And also we can discuss a lot of current issues. Every time I come to Europe, there seems to be current issues going on. I think this time I've come to Europe and there's been a lot of talk of refugees. Sometimes it's the Euro Cup. Or sometimes your scientists are discovering a new particle the Higgs boson particle. One time I came over, oh, we've discovered Higgs boson. We're going to call it the God particle. Very good, very good. So what? And I always have a lot to say about whatever is going on. One time I came and they said, oh, we've got a new, we're electing a new pope. From Argentina. Oh, very good. The white smoke's coming out here. So it's quite interesting to come to Europe because there's all kinds of, always something fascinating going on over here. I know every time I come, it's never be boring. There's always something interesting. Ah, welcome. Come on in. Do we should have chairs for both of you. I hope. Yep, there are two chairs. They counted them here. They very precise. Nothing slipped by here. Chris is like, yeah, that's good.
You're both from England, aren't you?
No. I'm from France.
You're from France? You're from England?
Yeah.
Okay. We were just talking about all the international guests. We missed you.
We recognize you, even underneath the beard and the hat.
Yeah, I'm in disguise.
You're in disguise.
Undercover.
Undercover. You thought you just slip in, nobody would notice you. You slip right in. No, here in Holland, everyone's very attentive. We can feel it when there's the slightest vibration change here. So we're going to have a very good week, I think, and we'll have lots of different aspects to the retreat. And I think for me, I also want you to feel that that you can really relax into this week. A lot of times you come to a retreat, and if it's got a lot of people, there's a certain bit of like, whoa, it's like, you know, your goldfish has been dropped into the pond, and you're not used to swimming with so many fish in the pond, and it's like a little bit of like, overload. But I want you to all just relax into the week, and I think that will be very helpful as we move along, if you just can ease in and relax and also feel like, again, this is tailored to you, so if there's something that you really feel you want to address or that would be helpful, please speak it up to us. Don't think that, well, it's just a large group and I have to just go along with the crowd and I'll just put up with it because I'm just one person. No, we're all the same mind, and this mind is very powerful. And we have a lot of nuances that come up, but it's very important to be attentive to those nuances so that everybody is benefiting. We want it to feel like everyone is benefiting as we move through the week. And also, I'd like to just say that I'm so grateful to be up here with my friends here because this has been a lifelong devotion. We've been diving into this for many, many years. And so there are many insights that come, but also it becomes just like a presence that's guiding us and carrying us. And for us, that's very dear, just this presence in our lives. And we want to extend that, and we know that it's in everyone's life, and it's just a matter of being in touch with it. So please feel free to ask us questions. We're very transparent as well. We know that our transparency has been very helpful in our healing of letting everything up and out, knowing we can put everything on the table. And we have lived by these guidelines for years of no people pleasing and no private thoughts. No people pleasing means we just say what's on our mind. And oftentimes that will lead to a much greater healing because we're not into denying and suppressing things. We want things to be up and out in the open. So we want you to feel free to ask any question. We won't be embarrassed, or we won't say, shh, stop, don't say that. which can be typical in this world, like talk about certain things and don't talk about other things. We trust that the Spirit is here with us and the Spirit can carry us all to a greater illumination, whatever the topic is. And so there are no off-limit topics. There are no taboo topics. And we feel like that's important in spirituality. We shouldn't have to, you know, push away from certain things and try to avoid things. We should trust the Spirit to purify our hearts and purify whatever needs to be purified. We don't have to avoid anything. So maybe we'll just, you want to go down the line, maybe Jenny, you can start off and share about yourself and your journey.
Okay, I'm Jenny. I feel just really grateful to be here. Just very warm and soft and open. I felt it even before I came that it was going to be that way. And I feel really joined with all of you, which was really good. I've been on this Course in Miracles path for 10 years, 11 years actually now. And very soon after I started to study the course, I met David. Because I had a very strong desire for God and for awakening, and I had no idea what it was going to look like, but it was as if I just drew forth the witness of David very, very quickly on my own spiritual journey and followed him or kind of gave myself over to spirit right away as I had met David. And it's been an extremely powerful, extremely fast, transformational journey of leaving everything behind that was not serving or not helpful for the awakening early on, about 8 years ago, and since then I have been just following the Spirit through inner guidance, through my mighty companions, through David. And it's been a huge undoing. It's been a lot of intensity for me, and a lot of light, a lot of deep joining, a lot of amazement, and a lot of just surprises, not knowing what's happening. But always this really, really beautiful adventure, and it still is. And like David said, it's like being on vacation, and it is, and it's like being so open to spirit and so available to whatever he wants me for, and I love that. So, and that invitation for everyone to be so open with your thoughts and your questions and the blocks that you want to heal. I just also want to emphasize how helpful that is, and that it actually helps everyone, and it is one mind, so please don't be afraid or don't hold back with anything, because we all, you know, we all feel the joy when something pops, and we all join in the healing, and there are no private thoughts, which is the most beautiful thing here. So I just want to thank you all for coming and joining in this great adventure. And I feel I will be available for one-on-ones, mostly in the afternoon, so let me know or let Luz know, and we can just have a time to meet and talk through anything. That's what's been given to me so much, and I just want to pass that on. It's just a helpful way, even if you don't know what to talk about. If there's some blocks, we can just come together and take a look at those blocks together. Much easier that way. Okay, thank you.
senses, and yeah, it's really, I'm really grateful to come back to the Netherlands. Last year, Chris organized a weekend retreat with about the same size, and probably has seen some of you from that retreat, but just really want to extend my gratitude for you to come all the way to be here with us, because my real devotion on this path started with a retreat with David back in Australia. Before that, I came across the course and I was reading it and having study groups for a couple of years before that. But when I came to the retreat for the first time and really gave myself over to it, my mind over to it, stepped out of my life completely for 6 days, that was the length that I went to, something really powerful happened. It was an experience that I invited to my awareness. And that really changed everything. So I just want to say that time is irrelevant, but if we allow ourselves to be really, really open and invite this experience, you know, there can be a huge transformation happening in an instant. So this is such a precious opportunity to, you know, to just come together, because since I left that retreat and decided to really give myself over for the rest of my life to a devotion to where spirit would guide me and live a life of total transparency and divine providence, I noticed what really matters is the purpose underneath everything we do. Because the form starts to become less and less relevant in the mind, and the purpose started to become more and more important in awareness. And I have to say, when we lived together over the last few years and traveled together, this becomes the only reason that we can keep going and the mind keeps extending, is because this unified purpose, that we don't have split purpose, that we want forgiveness and we want something else at the same time. It's like, let's go for forgiveness so fully and go for the spirit fully. And I feel this is what we have here, you know, for 5 days, all of us come together, step out of whatever distraction. Now we're going to have a unified purpose. It's going to be so powerful. And this is going to be a huge invitation. Mm-hmm. And over the years, I think my prayer to the spirit, probably something that I use the most with the spirit, has been any support. If this is the direction you want me to go, any support. And with specific things too, especially when I thought, really, this is radical. And I recognize that, maybe, but I don't know, I'm ready, I need support. And every time I start to open up to be willing to go there and request or ask for support, the amount of support that comes my way in my awareness just blows my mind. And I know that all of you must have this prayer somewhere in your mind. Whether you said it the same way or not, you must have said, I need support. Mm-hmm. And here we are. And all of us from different countries, different part of the world, because we are here to be open to the spirit's support coming in, you know, through our brothers, through words, through music, through very deep, profound movies, through our questions, through our one-on-one times and walks, meditations, So I just want to congratulate you, and you know, Spirit has heard the call, and it's so precious. And we're at your full service. That's what we're here for. We're at your service. Please use us. So thank you so much.
I feel that too. I was here in Holland just recently on a very spontaneous tour where I had actually a Lulu retreat once a day, because they turned out to be retreats. Every day was so full on with so much healing and so much beautiful things coming up. And people that just came for a day, they just poured out their heart into this experience of really joining on what, you know, what's on my heart, and then let it pour through and let the movie speak. Show exactly the same scenarios that you go through in your life, and let yourself have a retranslation by the help of the parables, or the modern day parables, like David says, through the movies. And so this is so powerful, of doing that both in the movies and in the music and in the conversations, of just really joining with the Spirit and asking for the help of the specific things that you're going through in your life. Now, this started for me, I just had to calculate. When Jenny, she said, oh, what year did I start studying the course? Because I wasn't quite sure. I think it was 2002. It was some years before I met David the first time in Sweden in 2005. And when I started studying the course, I knew that this could be an experience of what Jesus was talking about in the course. I knew that this is something that you can live. However, it was very high metaphysics, and in my course group, I couldn't even pick up the course, even read it, you know, 1 year after I'd been in my course group and just had poured out everything in my heart. Every time we met, I was like, what? You know, just whenever I would have on my mind, I would be like, what? You know, this is what's going on this week, you know. And I would just be so highly practical, because I couldn't do it in any other way. It just had to be exactly what I was going through, that the Spirit could help me and carry me further and further into myself, of who I really am. And so it completely resonated with me when I heard about this man that had been traveling with no money, no possessions, just nothing, in his car for 5 years, and he didn't even have a tent.
And it's a small car too. Wasn't a van, like a VW Christmas. It's three cylinders.
So I thought it was so amazing just meeting with David then in 2005, because I had felt in my heart this is possible. And when we met, it was like I mean, first of all, at that retreat, I couldn't sleep any nights. They were just like, I was being just so high on love and joy. And after that, I was like in joy for like 3 months afterwards, and I was just like so in love with everyone and everything, even my boyfriend at that time. You know, he asked me, even my
boyfriend.
No, not really, not that.
We're recording this.
Well, the boyfriend, he had actually proposed to me before, but I was just like not feeling it. And then all of a sudden it turned into falling in love with everyone. I was like, yes! You know, but what happened was that after those 3 months, he couldn't join with me in that joy. And I noticed how I was actually taking myself into another space in my mind, just because I couldn't join with him in it. And I fell down into, you know, the regular kind of the mode. And I saw that that was a choice. So then, the thing is though, that David kept on coming back to Sweden. He came over and over again, and we would join every time. And I would just go deeper and deeper into this experience, again, what the course is talking about, and just kind of, you know, filling out what this is actually all about. So, you know, you have been reading the course or somehow gotten in contact with it in a very beautiful way, that somehow it's spoken to you and it's felt. And that's what we're here it's so highly practical, like David was saying. It's like whatever that you have, that you're worthy of having it healed. That's the whole point. We're worthy. And just coming to see that, we're worthy to shine those who we are, not keeping that light in. And so I'm so looking forward to you know, join with you in this. Whatever the darkness, let it rip, you know. Don't hold back. It has to come out. It's through the darkness to the light. Otherwise, we cannot be in that high. So it's like letting it all hang out, let it look as it does, and then that's how you can shine who you are. So I'm so happy to be here. And the funny thing is, actually, I was being presented as a messenger of peace, which is interesting because I have been traveling with David from 2005. We started traveling the world, and then we like were together for 24/7, kind of a mind training situation. For me, really intense, and lots of healing coming up, and just pour through. And then another 4 years of living with Living Miracles and the community with friends all over the world and just joining on a daily basis in this kind of a mind training and just letting go together. And then, actually what happened just some year ago, I think it was 2005, I left Living Miracles as a full-time... 2015.
Everything happened
for 2000. Everything happened. You see, I just dropped time and space. It can kind of sometimes 10 years can just fall off like that. You see? So it's very hard for that. So the thing is, I actually felt that it's time for me to leave, but not the ministry. I'm still an ordained minister, and I'm still completely connected with all of this. So it's just that the form was changing, that I moved to Sweden and I have continued with the open heart that was coming through when I was joining with David and a bunch of musicians all over the world, just in very spontaneous ways of letting the Spirit just give music if it would be given. I wouldn't even know. I would just meet with people and all of a sudden you would have a song coming through, and all of a sudden David was saying, like, well, you have to have some kind of a name on this, you know. And I'm like, oh, okay. So I was praying on it, and I was feeling the open heart. And the open heart is the love of God. It's that which we are. When we open up to this open heart and let that come through, that's this beauty. We just open up the channel, and then it just pours through. And we can't help ourselves but just, like, glide into it. And so what would happen in this open heart expression, even before we would even know the word of it, would be that we would just come together having a jam session, and all of a sudden we would have a song like this in a one take. We would have all the lyrics, we would have all the music, and just everything given. So we would start recording when I would join with musicians like this, because it was no effort, where we see like these were just gifts for ourselves, but you know, we could actually also share it. And so we have been recording lots of those songs, and like Chris was saying, you have most of them here, otherwise they're online as well, but you will find them on the table here in the other room, just like the materials. And now you will hear all of it live, of all of the materials that are there. But the best part is that you can ask your questions and be so practical about this. So I'm inviting you, just like everyone else, into this experience. So thank you for coming and answering the call. It's just amazingly beautiful.
Yeah. So we've got some time here to kind of get going. I think Chris was saying that's what he remembered about the last time we were here. We had a group about this size. We were just here for a weekend, but we just jumped right in. From the get-go, we were just diving right in. And to me, that's what is so practical about this. You know, we've become accustomed to the human condition. We've become accustomed, you might say, to living a little life as one among the 7 billion. And our destiny is to transcend the identity that the ego made up for us, which is a very body-based, personality-based identity, that's very individual and autonomous, and to go into the greater joining, to go into a greater plan of awakening from this dream of sleep and coming to the vastness that we are as we were created by God. And to do it in a practical way, you can't skip any steps. You know, you can't just wish your way back into nirvana or wish your way back. You have to give yourself over to the spirit to rinse your mind and cleanse your mind, cleanse your consciousness of all the false beliefs, of all the limiting beliefs that the ego has given as a replacement for divine love. So this is very, very practical, and a lot of times we will share lots of examples because it helps to have examples of hearing what is possible. It helps to have metaphors. I think all of us, we've listened to a lot of music, we've had a lot of prayer and meditation, devotion. For us, being called, Chris really wanted to come to this place out in nature, and we all feel very, very natural out here in nature because we have spent a lot of our lives in nature. We're kind of like nature mystics in some way, even though I've gone into a lot of cities and spoken to a lot of people, and I'm quite comfortable as well in cities or wherever the body seems to be, but we've had experiences with a lot with animals, both animals that are out in nature. We have even a monastery in Utah where the chipmunks and the rabbits will come up to us. When you start to get into a very peaceful, relaxed, joyful state of mind, and the animals come right to you. They'll come up, come jump on your jeans. They want to get close to you. Very much like St. Francis over here with Assisi. We're experiencing a lot of the same things. I was walking one time with a friend of mine down a road in Kentucky, and it was very hot, and the road had a lot of gravel and rocks on it. So all the butterflies came out and were all along the road. They loved to sit on the hot rocks and sunbathe. So I was walking with my friend Dorothy, and she burst into laughter one time, and she was laughing so hard. I said, "Okay, what's so funny?" She said, "Well, you have a butterfly on you." I said, "Where?" And she says, "It's on your butt." It's riding on your butt as you walk down this road. It's like, okay. So I put my finger out like this, and in my mind, I just kept inviting. I said, "Have a front row. You can ride right on the tip of my finger if you want to." So for a few minutes, and then she burst into laughter when it flew around and did land on the tip of my finger and ride there. So another benefit of this high level of trust, of this high level of transparency, open communication, you know, all the good stuff that we know is helpful. If you do it enough and you devote your life to it, then you start to become more telepathic. Some of you might remember, I believe it was after Paul McCartney, he left the Beatles and he was part of Wings, and he had that song, "My Love." "Don't ever ask me why I never say goodbye to my love. It's understood. It's in the hands of my love, and my love does it good." Isn't that beautiful? It's like a communion experience. "Don't ever ask me why I never say goodbye." Wow. That's a communion experience. That's really what love is about. When you feel that communion where it's in your heart and it's just flowing so strong, and then there's really no goodbyes and no hellos. It's just ever with you. It's you just experiencing your divinity with everything and everyone around you. And that's really what spirituality is about. It's about opening up, using good spirit-inspired communication to take you to an experience of communion in which you don't need the words. anymore. Some of you might remember the singer Gloria Estefan. But the words get in the way. There's so much I want to say. I try to say I love you, but the words get in the way. We want to come into a communion experience where we let the Spirit use the words so beautifully, so thoroughly, so fully, in purpose, in presence, that there's just this peaceful understanding. And then words are simply used to bless. You know, everything that comes out of your mouth then just becomes a blessing for the whole universe. That's really all speaking is really for, is to offer a blessing. I remember when I was much younger, my parents had said to me one time, if you don't have anything good to say, don't say anything at all. And this is kind of a version of that. It didn't really prepare me for all the healing that would be necessary to go through to come to that sense of blessing and goodness. But actually, that's what this is aiming for. And now it's gotten to the point where it's just the words come very naturally. They just roll out as part of a healing and blessing. I did have a funny experience. I just came here from England. And I was just south of London, I think it was in Sussex, and afterwards some people came up, and during things, they said, during the breaks, oh, can you sign my book, sign my book? Well, this woman came up to me, and she gave me a book, and she gave me a pen, and she said, can you sign my book? I said, sure. And she said, write something rude. The first time on the planet. In all these years, I mean, earlier, I didn't have books, so nobody said, sign my cassette, or you know, something. That dates me. Phone booths, cassettes. No, this was like, can you write something rude? And I had to come there, but everything's involuntary now, so I had my pen, and I looked, and I saw her name, and I put the name down. But I couldn't write anything rude in her, in one of these beautiful books that the Spirit has given me. And so she just looked at me, and obviously it wasn't anything rude coming out. And so I just kind of smiled, opened my eyes, and she said, do something cheeky. Cheeky! So I tried for that too. Nothing cheeky would come out of me. So she said, well, just put whatever there. I forget what I wrote, but it's something like that. I always like to read what I write. Ooh, that's good.
Oh. Kenneth,
you say Kenneth.
Nickname of Francis and I. Can we say it, Kenneth?
Sorry?
Can we say it, what you call Francis and I?
Yeah, you
can
say it.
Because you cheeky devils. That's pretty rude, too. But we could hear it came from his loving heart.
Cheeky devils. That's why he's undercover. He comes with his hat. But, you know, in the end, you just have to be authentic and just whatever's in there, to come, let it come. You don't censor it in any way. Because it's the censoring that brings the hesitation. If we have a critical voice in our mind, or we have a voice that's censoring and talking to us but saying, don't say this, don't do this, you know, it's kind of censoring and controlling, that's the ego. And in the end, I would say that when we give our mind over to miracles, miracles are involuntary in nature and should not be under conscious control. So it should become as easy and as right as breathing. Like, you don't have to think as you move through your day, in-breath, out-breath, in-breath. You know, imagine how much effort that would take to think in-breath, out-breath, all day long. And we can start to relax so that our whole life can become that involuntary flow. And it's very joyful and very gleeful and very spontaneous and also very restful, because there's nothing, there's no inner judge in there saying, you should do this, why didn't you say that, and could you do this a little bit more? You know, that little voice is always telling us things aren't perfect, oh, they're far from it, and it's always telling us we have to change things. When actually our divine nature is changeless, we were created to be pure, changeless spirit, and then change is coming in from the ego. It's wanting us to constantly be ever-changing. They have an ever-changing identity instead of a changeless, pure spirit identity. So, I really feel we're going to have a lot of opportunities, and we also brought a hard drive that has a huge amount of movies. So what we can do is, it's got over 1,000 movies, so what we can do is, as we start to see some of the themes and things that you're coming up with, there are some really spectacular movies that the Spirit can show, along with some amazing commentary that can be very insightful, kind of help you, you know, pop the cork in your mind of going past being stuck with certain patterns. You may have been stuck in those patterns for many years, but the Spirit can pop the cork and set you free, and then you'll see you have so much more vitality and energy. So these can be amazing movies.
Yes. Yes, David, can I make a suggestion already? Or
yes, please do, yeah.
Okay. I was in this weekend, you were here before, and I liked very much to do the exercises, no private thoughts, as well in a group as individual. And right now, when you said when there's themes, you want to have in the movies, jealousy is a theme for me at the moment itself.
Okay. Very good.
If you have a movie about that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can think of a few off the top of my head.
I don't want to.
Yeah.
Jenny bought a hard drive right before this, and 3 terabyte hard drive to put the all our movie collections to come. Because we want this retreat to be so spontaneous, under the Christ control, under the Spirit's control. So we're like, be on cue, whatever Spirit prompts us to do, whichever movie that we don't have any preparation, but we're fully prepared. Mm-hmm. On the day when the issue comes up, that is going to be the movie, you know, as we're going to use a movie to such an extent that really address the things, the themes come up in the mind. And as you mentioned about the expression sessions, so it is a retreat that really takes your participation, because whatever you have on your heart, whatever you have in your life that burdens you, burdens your heart and your mind, isn't really separate from your mind. And these 5 days is an opportunity that you give yourself permission to allow whatever that wants to be looked at and wants to be healed to come up, rise up to the surface. And your issue is not yours alone. That's the beauty of it, because whatever that is on the surface of mind and is so ready to be released is actually for everyone.
Yeah, I find it very amazing that Spirit always tailor-made the solution for us. And through my years with David, it's been like, if I have an issue up, the Spirit is actually offering a movie or something that is completely perfect for me to look at that issue. And actually, I do recognize the issue of jealousy myself. And years ago, I was dealing with it, and David said, let's go to the movies. And he took me to a movie called The Other Bolain Girl, maybe some of you have seen it. But it was so perfect. It was those two girls that, sisters and the same man, and one was like got pregnant and got close in the room, and while the man went with the other girl, and it was just so intense to face that jealousy. And so I love, you know, I love how we can pray when you share your issue, and just pray and see what Spirit has, and it would be the perfect answer.
If I can make a contribution to what I just said, for me it's not jealousy, well, I know the forms are just the forms, it's not jealousy like in a love relationship, it's jealousy that, and it's changing already, but I'm jealous at people who dare to expose themselves on YouTube, or just like I'm talking now.
The feeling itself, right? Right. You've come out of the whole group and you're exposing yourself.
I'm always too afraid to do this, but
yeah, that's beautiful. That's a good example. And I think when I was here last, I do remember some amazing movies and clips that we showed. We started to kind of lean it over towards a quantum perspective. What's a quantum perspective? It's a holistic perspective of the world. It's the big picture of the world. It's seeing that the world is actually simultaneous instead of linear. And it's seeing that, you know, it's going into that quantum experience. And since I was here last, I think I've published this book called Quantum Forgiveness, where I have 7 movies to, as practical experiences to go into, you know, to literally set your mind up by reading the book and get yourself ready then to watch these movies, or one of them is a Star Trek episode called The Emissary. But that's really spectacular, where you can start to let your whole perspective on the whole world do like a complete shift from a linear perspective, from the timeline, and to the moment, to come to the point of seeing the world completely differently. And then you'll see that whatever the issues and themes were, it was just an attempt to hold on to the linear. So we do talk a lot about that, about Isaac Newton and Newtonian physics, and then we talk about quantum physics as literally transcending the whole linear model. That, you know, it's like that, there's a song that Little River Band did from Australia, and it's, there are so many paths up the mountain, nobody knows all the ways, there are so many paths up the mountain, but the view from the top is still the same. And at one point in that song there's a great lyric, forget what you've ever learned. And that's really what A Course in Miracles is trying to help us do in a very systematic way. Forget the past, forget what we've learned, and come into a fresh new perspective that's basically free of the past.
I would like to ask something to begin with here, because before I went here, I felt how the fear of death is coming up very strongly, because I had some glimpses of truth, and I knew when I come here the light will be so immense, and my whole body started to tremble and shake, and I was like, it was like, as I'm ego-identified, it was like you are walking into an open life. I come here and I'm gonna die. And this is an immense fear that I carry right now. And the other fear is that like darkness will pop up so extremely that I'm gonna, I don't know, shout and cry and fight, and this is something I would, yeah. I don't know.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm sure we'll all be watching as the week goes along, but yeah, thank you for exposing that. Well, Marianne is going to grace us with a song. And then after that, we will head out towards lunch, to go experience lunch. And we'll be back, as Chris said, at 2 o'clock. So we can try to all come back to the room and get settled.
To the same
room,
to be a helper sharing.
2, 2, 2.
Hello, everybody. Can you hear well? Yeah. David asked me to sing this song. It's from Susan McCollum, and it's about you can relax now. But I'm also going to say it to myself. So maybe you can do just something. Just put your feet square on the floor, and just feel your butt on the chair, and just take an inhalation.
Time if you can walk. Yeah.
to you too.